18 years ago, we started an organization called IP, Institute for Ecological Research, my wife and I and some researchers. Now we have 100 people working for us in different areas like research and conservation, education and sustainability. I want to call your attention for two areas that we produced that ended up in creating the conservation model. This conservation model that goes from a single species to education, to community, to landscape, and to policy. And then has also participation and research from the communities in the development of the model. In this model, we are applying in five areas of Brazil. We have more than 40 projects. In each area, we have in the center of the area, a protected area, and surrounding it, we work with the communities to have sustainable business there. And this sustainable business led into the more protection for the protected areas. And we started in the Atlantic Forest. The Atlantic Forest is almost gone, and there is only 30% left. We learned how to do restoration and reforestation in the Atlantic Forest and how to implement the projects. But then, and these projects also brought us to reforestation and how to produce seedlings and how to plant trees and how to create tree nurseries together with the communities so we can bring income to the community, so we can bring income to the people in the region. We have 16 of these tree nurseries that produce 300,000 seedlings a year, and we have another one that produces another 300,000. In this way, we move to the landscape and work with the communities in a way that we plant corridors, we restore the landscape so we can have agriculture, and at the same time, we can have trees, and at the same time, we have a community with more income. And coffee and forest is one of our main strategies. And this slide is to tell you that many companies are now with us in this effort, and show that the private sector is very much interested in getting involved in all these issues. We need regulations, and we need ways that they can do it on a easier and simpler way. Now moving to Amazonia. Amazonia is 50% of Brazil. It's a very important 20% of the biodiversity of the world. It's 1/4 of the water of the world. And it also has a lot of communities, 20 million people living there. And deforestation was a main issue in Amazonia, although it has been reduced in recent years, especially in Brazil, to an effort from the Brazilian government. But I want to think that this is a trend, but we have to be very careful because it might come back. And part of the strategy was the creation of protected areas. More than 150 million hectares of protected areas are now in Amazonia, Brazilian Amazonia, and more than 100 million from indigenous peoples in reserves. And it's a very important part of the story because it ends up in creating more protection. But as you can see by this graph, the effort of creation of protected areas was very big, but in recent years, we are not creating anymore. In the last 2 years, only 400,000 hectares were created in comparison to 67 million created in the last 5 years. So this is because there is a pressure against the creation. And this brings us to the idea that the private land can be used for protection as well. We can involve private land and the private sector in the process of conservation. In Amazonia, there is 1/4 of the Amazonia belongs to the private sector. And the government also has a role to play. And with this idea in mind, a group of Brazilian businessmen, some of the most important of our businessmen, together with us, created a company called Biofilica. And Biofilica is a 2.5 company between the second and third sector, has a mission of 5 million hectares of privately protected area. And this is the model. The model includes the privately protected area, some organizations that will do the management of the area, and then Biofilica that will run funds and manage funds that will buy credits and at the same time get money from investors to invest in the whole model. This way, we are now working in looking for private areas in Amazonia. We have a pipeline in our company with 7 million hectares. We have signed one agreement with 102 hectares, but the problem is land tenure and land title. And we are looking more and more for how to solve that. And that's one of the main problems.